What are we going to look at today then?
These learners are taking part in a session on adulthood as part of their health and social care course. They are looking at the average height of males from countries across the world. The maths activities in this session have been produced to help the learners progress further through the course.
We're aware that there's quite a gap between them coming from school to where they are now, where maths isn't actually at the forefront of their mind. They haven't done maths for a while. We have to sell it to the students as to why maths is relevant within health and social care.
And I want you to line up at the back of the room. So the tallest country on this side to the smallest on this side.
Okay. The session begins with an activity to get the learners thinking about global average heights for males.
We all got given different countries and we had to line up in order of what we thought the height was in that country, the average height.
And they had to have reasons as to why they thought perhaps Philippines was the tallest and why Norway was the shortest, for instance.
Right, so we've gone from United Kingdom being the tallest. All right, we've got some Scandinavian countries in the middle and we've got China, the Philippines and the Gambia on this side. So, why are you stood at that end?
Because I thought it was close to France.
Because you think we're taller than France?
Well, no, I thought it would be close to France because
they're... Yeah.
So they were coming up with some really good things, actually, such as diet in particular countries and looking at living conditions.
Open your envelopes.
The learners now open the envelopes to see what the average height in each country is and reorder themselves accordingly. Because the average heights have been taken from an international source and are presented in a way that may be unfamiliar to the learners, it is an opportunity to discuss imperial and metric units and consider the best way to manage the international data. It is decided to round each height to the nearest inch. For the next activity, the learners now have to convert their heights from imperial to metric units.
We were looking at the difference between imperial and metric because of the different service users that they'd be coming across. The older generation perhaps still working in imperial, where the newer generation and perhaps those coming from overseas from Europe, they prefer working in a metric.
We should just add them together.
We can do that and see what you come up with, first of all. So do you think somebody is realistically 87.5 centimetres?
Six-year-old child isn't going to be like 200 centimetres tall.
So. Yes, if it comes out like that, you can quite easily guess, well, that's not going to be right, I'm going to try this calculation again.
Personally, I work it out through, I know I'm around 165 centimetres, so I can work out how tall, on average it is, from how tall I am.
I think they cope very well with maths, because I'm very aware that some of them are doing retakes in maths, so are probably fresher with some of these ideas than others, and I think that we had a good group where we had, I think it was one on each table that was actually resitting maths, so they could bring their knowledge to it and support the others. I think doing maths in a group exercise, or doing it individually but supportive of their friends, is actually good, and comparing.
Everyone seems to be struggling. They might try and get us to work together as a class. Like, yeah, everyone right. might know little bits and sort of put it together and see if we can work it out ourselves between us.
If a couple of students get it in the class, you'll get the student to do it, because obviously we'll understand better if a student will tell us, because they'll use language we understand.
You some graphs.
Then we moved on to looking at graphs too. We had the Chinese, the Norwegian and the World Health Authority charts, and they were interpreting the graphs.
This Bergen growth study, what can you already tell on the blue line compared to the yellow line, which is the World Health Authority average?
Slightly above it.
Yeah, okay. And that sort of plays into what we were looking at earlier with the Norwegian people, Scandinavian people, being slightly taller on average. This is the Chinese growth chart then, so we've already decided...
The graphs show that in China, the length of a child is below the average in the world, whereas the Norwegian chart shows that it's a little bit above average.
Basically, it shows the average length of a child from when it's been born up to 24 months. So, and it shows us, like, on average, they're all about 50 when the child's born, but as you go to 24 months, the age gap, the length does increase. It was only like a couple of centimetres, but you can imagine if that continues, that's going to end up being quite a big gap.
They struggled with the graphs a little bit more. This is perhaps something that they're not as used to. Maths they see as adding up and taking away, and mental arithmetic. So actually interpreting data is something perhaps a little bit new and a little bit alien to them. Perhaps without grid lines that they're used to as well was a little bit more challenging. But with the support that they were giving each other and the support I was able to give them, they did come up with the goods. So perhaps that's an area that moving on I could incorporate more into a lesson, just to enhance their skills with interpreting data like that. But again, work needs to be challenging. We need to stretch and challenge our students, so this was an ideal opportunity to do that. So we covered quite a large amount of maths, probably in about 25 minutes, which would be probably a third of the session. But it was meaningful. It was getting them to think about how it could be used in health and social care and how it's important, while still linking into adulthood and the assignment that they're going to be doing later on.
This is more relevant, yeah. And the stuff that actually you do see how to use it, and it is more straightforward and it is easier because you can think how to apply it to day-to-day situations rather than when you're learning something, you're like, but when am I going to use this?